please. First of all, on behalf of my independent colleagues and myself, I'd like to extend our deepest condolences to the family of Emma Vicvahuna and to salute her great courage and dignity. Taoiseach, yesterday's budget, I think, was the 12th delivered together by yourselves and Fianna Fáil, going back to 2009, and of course it's the third of this current de facto coalition. One of the constant themes of all of those budgets, and all the earlier ones, was the widespread use of total government revenue forgone in your joint policy of tax expenditures, like, for example, your tax relief, extra tax relief yesterday for your landlord friends. The 2014 Department of Finance report, of course, defines tax expenditures, and I quote, as reducing tax obligations with respect to a benchmark tax rather than by direct expenditure, end quote. And secondly, I quote, provisions that reduce or postpone revenue for a comparatively narrow population of taxpayers relative to the tax base, end quote. And of course, these expenditures include, as you well know, exemptions, allowances, credits, deferrals, etc. But they're hugely significant, as outlined in the briefing paper 13, 2018, by our excellent Parliamentary Budget Office. Even excluding benchmark taxes, the income taxes, the PBO estimates a basic tax expenditure cost of over $5 billion in 2016, rising from $4.7 billion in 2014. But these estimates are based only on 2016 data, and data for some of the largest tax expenditures in 2016 are still not available. Even still, in 2016, tax expenditures comprised nearly 11% of total tax revenue and 9% of total voted expenditure. Just before I came to the Dáil for this debate, I understand that the 2017 report on expenditures was finally published. But Taoiseach, why isn't it part of the budget book? A lot of us were looking for it yesterday in the expenditures report, and simply it wasn't there. And can you tell me, Taoiseach, what is the cost of the 2017 tax expenditures and the projected costs for 2018 and 2019. As you know, unlike 14 other EU states, there's no legislative requirement here for regular parliamentary debates and scrutiny of tax expenditures. There's also the added difficulty that we have revenue figures, we have Department of Finance figures, Department of Finance reports, and I've studied them closely. They're very incomplete, even going back to 2014. But the scale of these expenditures is indeed vast. In 2016, for example, the R&D tax credit cost $670 million, CAT agricultural relief cost $141 million in 2017, film relief cost $87.6 million in 2015, and a range of relief supporting business cost nearly $560 million in 2016, and share-based remuneration $74 million. I think that's in the current in today's report. But many of these, they've never been expenditures, Taoiseach, as you know, they've never been reviewed or assessed, and the mass of taxpayers, our people, are still paying out for several pre-crash tax relief and avoidance schemes. And I think the PBO rightly says tax expenditures, they represent a departure from the equity principle of taxation, and they give rise to rent-seeking behaviour by favoured taxpayers. And the PBO, of course, also comments on the fiscal illusory effect that tax expenditures, when they're perceived as a tax cut, when they're actually spending increases. So will you accept, Taoiseach, the key recommendations of our Parliamentary Budget Office for systematic ex-ante reviews of all tax expenditures, for a definitive list of all benchmark measures, for enhanced costing methods, and for much approved access, availability and transparency of data on these expenditures? And would you legislate, Taoiseach, perhaps in the Finance Bill, to put this responsibility with the PBO and with our Budget Oversight Committee, chaired, of course, by your colleague, Deputy Colin Brophy.
Thank you, Deputy.
Thanks, Ken.
Taoiseach.
I think Deputy Bruin's a little bit fuzzy in his political history, suggesting that this is the 12th budget.
It's like walking into the lobbies. You saw yourself, and then I saw on the last call, the Fianna Fáil is tripping up behind you.
Yeah, as... As I was saying, I think Deputy Bruin's a little bit fuzzy in his recollection in talking about this being the 12th budget. It's the third of this government involving Fine Gael and independence under the Constant Supply Agreement. And the previous five budgets before that were Fine Gael and Labour, and I think you were in that coalition briefly. I'm not sure whether you ever managed to vote for a budget. I certainly don't think you ever will, but I'm pretty sure you were you were briefly part of that government, at least until it came to the point of having to make a difficult decision. So I'm sure you will. I'm sure you'll spend many years in this House, but will never actually have to vote for a budget. And I suppose for people like that sort of politics, that is the sort of politics that they like. In relation to tax expenditures, I think it's important to say at the outset tax expenditures are there for a reason. Sometimes they're a good idea, sometimes they're a bad idea, and they have to be regularly reviewed and have to be justifiable in my view. So, for example, one of the most expensive tax expenditures we have is mortgage interest relief, where we allow people to pay or offset some of their income tax against the cost of their mortgage. And that was introduced to promote home ownership and to help people pay their mortgages. And hundreds of thousands of people around the country will have benefited from that over the years. Child benefit not being taxed is also a tax expenditure. And we took a decision as a government that we would not tax child benefit as income. And that was designed to help parents out with the cost of looking after their kids. If you hire a carer or a nurse to come into your home, for example, to look after an elderly relative, again, you can offset that against your income tax. That is a tax expenditure. We have ones for business as well, the EIS, which replaced the BES, designed to encourage people to invest in business, thus creating jobs. A film one, which has been hugely successful in bringing films to Ireland, creating jobs all over the country. There's one for workers' expenses. So, for example, if you work in a particular job and you need certain uniforms and equipment, you can offset that against your income tax. There used to be one for trade union subscriptions. I imagine you'd like to bring that one back. Some people want to bring one in for rent again. The R&D one is obviously there to produce R&D. And there's a very expensive one where we don't require people to pay capital gains tax if they sell their family home. Recognising that the family home is something very particular in Ireland, and that if you do sell a family home, you don't have to pay capital gains tax on that. It's not treated as an investment property. So when you do talk about tax expenditures, you need to talk about them in the round, understand that they are all there for a reason. But yes, of course, it must be a good reason, and they must be regularly reviewed and amended.
Thank you, Taoiseach.
Thanks, Dan. Well, just on your earlier remarks, Taoiseach, I do hope still it's my ambition to be a member of a left-led Irish government. I'll take whatever decisions have to be taken when I believe that will happen. But I am fully aware of the socio-economic reasons for many tax expenditures. The issues I'm raising here today are ones of definitions, costings, and above all, transparency, systematic evaluation, and including sunset clauses. The current presentation, the way yesterday, we didn't get it in the budget book. It's just frankly unacceptable, Taoiseach. I think you'd agree with that yourself. We've got to have the full picture and the full stats for our constituents. The EU Commission, of course, a few years ago, they looked at tax expenditures across the Union, and they said, of course, they amount to what it called a non-negligible share of GDP in virtually every member state. But it ranged from small percentages of GDP, like 1 and 2% in Germany and France, up to 9 to 11%, I think, for the UK ourselves and Italy, and we seem to be one of the kind of higher outliers. So I just wondered, do you or your government, do you ever intend to have maybe a target cap on expenditures, and within what range? And as I said, you didn't answer me in relation to the figures for say 2017, because you don't know them actually, and nobody in this House really knows them, because the costings haven't been done. So what I'm asking you, can we set up a system of accountability, insert it perhaps into the finance bill? The Budget Oversight Committee and the Parliamentary Budget Office, they've been one of the great successes of this Dáil for ex-ante evaluation and working closely with all the agencies. So I'm just asking you, Taoiseach, will you legislate, therefore, give us responsibility to do this so that the next year's budget we'll have a fair idea of where all the money is going?
Thanks, Cam. Conclude, please.
I don't have any plans to legislate on this, but I imagine the Department of Finance is able to provide that information for the Deputy by means of a parliamentary question. I assume the Department of Finance has estimates, estimates as to what the tax foregone is from any particular tax expenditure or tax incentive. And I know the Commission on Taxation, although admittedly it is a number of years ago, examined all of them and had a detailed view on each of them. In terms of sunset clauses, you can do that. When we reduced VAT for the tourism and hospitality sector, we indicated that it would only last for 3 years, although that wasn't written into the law. When you have a sunset clause, you always come under pressure to extend anyway, so I'm not sure how effective they are. And I certainly wouldn't have a sunset clause when it comes to exempting child benefit from income tax, and I wouldn't have a sunset clause when it comes to exempting the sale of a family home from capital gains tax. And I'd be concerned if that's the kind of policy the Deputy is putting forward, that there would be a threat put in law that at a certain point we're going to start taxing your child benefit.
All right. Thank you, Taoiseach. That concludes leaders' questions.